Ray casting is the process of shooting an invisible ray from a point in a specified direction to detect whether any colliders lay in the path of the ray. One such example of this would be shooting a gun. In this instance, our character wants to shoot the evil box that betrayed him and killed his father. The syntax of the raycast function looks like this. It can be confusing at first, but once you understand what each part does, it makes much more sense. Firstly, the origin of the ray is a point in world space. So in this instance, we'd choose a point in front of the barrel of the gun stored as a vector 3, an x, y, and z position. However, because our world coordinates direction won't be facing in the direction we are shooting, we'll need a second vector 3 to store our direction in. These two vector 3 variables make up our ray, but we can also substitute in a ray variable, as this data type can store two vector 3s. Our code would then look like this. The next argument in the function is a rayCastHit variable that stores information on the collider's hit so that it can be queried in code as to which objects are intersected by the ray. Finally, there are two optional arguments: distance, which defines the length of the ray, if omitted the ray will default to an infinite length, and layer mask. This is the number of a particular layer in Unity's layer system on which you can place objects if you wish to make the ray ignore them. Let's look at another practical example of using raycasting. In this example, we have a parachute crate that opens a parachute when it's nearing the floor. The crate is made up of two parts, the chute and the crate itself. The chute has two animations, one to open the chute and another to close it. In this example, we'd need to cast the ray downwards in order to see how far the crate is from the floor. And we check for the floor by looking for the environment collider. Our collider for the environment is tagged with the word environment. And in our script, we are looking for that tag. The raycast function gets put into an if statement, so that if it returns true, i.e. if it intersects with anything, then the commands within the if statement will be carried out, and the raycast hit info can be queried as to what has been hit. So within an if statement, we are saying physics.raycast, we have a landing ray variable that's storing the position of the box and a downward direction. We're using the shortcut vector3.down, and we're using this as the ray to cast. Our raycast hit variable hit is storing anything that gets hit by the ray as it's cast downwards, and the distance or length of the ray is defined by our deployment height variable. If the ray intersects with a collider that has a tag environment, as we know ours does, then we call the deploy parachute function. This function then simply sets our Boolean deployed flag to true, so that this cannot repeat. And then we set the drag of the rigid body to the variable parachute effectiveness, so we slow down the crate as if it's being held up by the parachute. We then play the animation on the object parachute, which is a game object that we'll assign to the public variable. We then have a separate onCollisionEnter, which simply plays the closing. So we know that as soon as it hits the ground or another object, the parachute can close. So here we've set the length of the ray to 4 by setting 4 as our deployment height, and we're setting the drag of the rigid body to 8 by setting the parachute effectiveness to 8. And we've simply dragged our parachute chute object onto the parachute variable, because this is the object that has an animation component in order to play back its opening and closing animations. So let's see that play one more time. It's also worth keeping in mind that although you cannot see raycasts drawn in the scene view or in the game, you can also use the debug.drawRay function in order to preview where a ray will be going. By adding debug.drawRay, we're saying to draw a visual ray from the position of the box in the direction of vector 3 down, multiplied by the deployment height, so our existing length of the ray. And by doing this, we've matched the actual ray that we're casting in the if statement below. So when we play this back, you can see that Unity demonstrates the ray by showing us the draw ray in the scene view.